Bryan, it's kind of funny to think how we're on the opposite end of the spectrum.
Now, historically speaking, we've had snow in April and in May in Kansas City, so we'll have to wait and see, but I don't think we're going to be breaking this record anytime soon. So as you talked about, we have just the opposite of what's happening in Anchorage. We have not much snow to speak of, although frost and freeze warnings are not too far away from us. I'll show you that in the Upper Plains states in just 1 minute. But just to reminisce, as we're still looking at this record in Kansas City, these are the least snowiest seasons, all less than 10 inches for the entire year. We should get about 18 to 21, and 3.9 is still holding by the fingernails from last year going through this season 2012. Now, of course, if we pick up anything that adds to that, we may go for second place. But right now, as every day gets longer and longer, that possibility looks smaller and smaller. City View camera on this Easter Sunday, plenty of sunshine and 66 degrees this hour. Southwest winds at 10 miles per hour. Humidity quite low at about 28%. Nothing low about these temperatures. All in the 60s, 68 degrees as you head out towards Sedalia and Lake of the Ozarks. Close to 70 Butler and down toward Clinton, 67 in Salina. Farther out to the east, really not that much cooler either. 66 in Kirksville, one of the chilly ones, as well as Chillicothe. Here it is on clouds and radar. Mostly clear conditions continue across the region as high pressure will definitely be on the throne for many, many days. Here are the freeze watches and warnings. The warnings in the light blue, the watch area up in the darker blue, which is just to the north of, say, state line. So it does include Iowa, good portion of the northern plain states and the western Great Lakes. So we're not going to be dipping down into the middle 30s to lower 30s, but nonetheless to the north. That colder air is not that far away. So here in Kansas City, shirt sleeve weather, middle 50s, maybe need that jacket after the sun does lower. It'll cool down fairly rapidly, about 51 degrees by midnight, but we'll stop at 46 with light winds, clear skies, a fairly smooth commute for you tomorrow morning. Want to widen it out once again and show you how expansive that area of colder air. The high pressure center is sitting down just not too far away from us, so that cooler air continues to spill in all throughout the northern plain states. And we're going to be right on the fringes, which is why it's going to be so cool in the low 40s, and that's why the kids need the jacket in the morning. But notice how it bounces back pretty quick to the 50s by mid-morning, 62 degrees by noon, 67 near perfection, plenty of sunshine by late in the day, mostly clear skies after the sun goes down, comfortable conditions. We'll fall back to 54, but it looks dry for Monday and probably Tuesday, and probably going into Wednesday as well, as this big area of high pressure continues to control the skies out there. But look out to the west. As we're looking at our next storm system currently moving through, say, the Aleutian Chain all over the western portion of Alaska, another storm system winding its way many hundred miles offshore. These will be the next storm systems heading toward us, and this is the way it's going to play out. Thursday, sunshine to start with, then a chance of rain for the second half of the day. And the same holds true for Friday and Saturday. Pre-dawn rain showers, a break in the middle, and then another chance of rain through the evening and overnight, both Friday and Saturday. So it does look like there's plenty of dry time in between dodging drops. That'll be the second half of the work week. This is your 7-day forecast, and it shows that temperatures will start off fairly cool Tuesday morning, 38 to 62 degrees on Tuesday, 39 to 60 on Wednesday. The cooler air stays around. Then it gets wet once again late Thursday into Friday and off and on Saturday and Sunday. Temperatures bouncing back so the lows won't be that cool in the 40s and the 50s. And right now it looks like at least a 30% chance to start things off late Thursday, 40% chance on your Friday, a couple thunder showers as well. Saturday, 50-50 shot at rain, mainly pre-dawn, then late evening. Rain showers also on Sunday, and it doesn't stop there. Latest information still looks like another chance the following Monday into the following Tuesday. So we're looking a couple of weeks in advance, and advanced tracking for you. So definitely the first half of the week is looking dry. Second half starts to get wet again.